Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is Ziggo Twist 2. So, you have seen my original Ziggo Twist puzzle, yet another variation to Bram Cohen's Ziggurat puzzle. And I asked the question, how could we further improve this puzzle that it becomes more meaningful? So, for this puzzle, and well, for both puzzles, you have pieces that rotate, and when you rotate them a bit, then you need to do a whole sequence to get everything reoriented. So Ziggo Twist 2 was my solution, because for this one, when you solve the puzzle, then you can take the pieces out of the frame. So the whole thing, the pieces are separate from each other. So we make a rotation like this, then rotate this one back, forward, this one. Let's see, I keep forgetting. Yeah, no, I'm going the wrong direction. Anyway, you see, it's a lot of movement, but once we have all the pieces down, it's possible to slide them out from here. And it took me quite a few prototypes to make this work. Actually, the number of moves is too many for a demonstration right now, so you need to believe me that it works. But here are some of the earlier prototypes where things either got stuck or, this prototype, actually, it was too easy, because you could just simply force the pieces and then get them out. And of course, these are illegal moves, it just took a bit of forcing. So everything needed to be tighter together. So yet another prototype where things were already more tight, and yet another prototype. And ultimately, I got the dimensions right, but even with the dimensions right, it's possible to cheat. So it's much better than all the earlier prototypes, but still it's a challenge to get this printed right. Anyway, it's a fun puzzle, and it's solvable, and it has a goal: get all the pieces out. And my question to you is about the category of puzzle. I call this binary because when you add a piece, then the number of moves doubles. So if you solve it with only two pieces, or three, or four, or five, or six, for every one that you add a piece, the number of moves doubles. So I call it binary. However, other people say, well, since each piece has four states, one, two, three, four, this is actually a quaternary puzzle. So my question to you is, would you call this a binary puzzle, or a quaternary puzzle, or generally an n-ary puzzle? Thank you for watching.